spark. Back-to-back threes. Here's Chandler now. Tennessee back in it. Chandler with a smile. And it's the Volunteers on a 9-0 run.
Basketball came into my life probably when I was about 5 years old. Everybody in my family had played basketball. My granddad, he played 3 sports, baseball, football, basketball. My dad played basketball, but neither of them played it in college. So, you know, basketball's always been a sport, you know, I've always been around. They influenced me just by saying, we're not gonna force you to, you know, play basketball. If you wanna play basketball, it's up to you. You wanna work hard, you work hard. So I decided, I always played football and basketball, so I decided just stick with one sport. My sixth grade year, I stopped playing football after when I went to middle school. So, you know, I just continued to work hard and, you know, I always pushed myself. And, you know, my dad's my biggest influencer and my granddad as well. They always pushed me, you know, to be the best player I could be.
It's no secret Kennedy Chandler was meant to play basketball. And before he even stepped foot on Rocky Top, he was already nationally known for his skills on the court.
All that recognition, you know, I just, you know, try to remain humble and, you know, just continue to work hard, you know, just a blessing, you know, for me to have all them accomplishments. And, you know, I know it wasn't done yet.
Because what he had left to accomplish was here at Tennessee.
I love it here. Honestly, ever since I stepped foot on campus, the fans are incredible. Going out here, going to the football games, you know, watching my two best friends play football, Jabari Small and Amari Thomas. You know, I know them since second grade. Just coming here and them coming to watch me play basketball, you know, supporting me, you know. It's really fun here. So, you know, for us to be at the same college, you know, it's just crazy. The difference from college basketball to high school and AAU, just everybody's good. It's not one person that's not good, or everybody, the speed of the game's faster than high school and AAU. Just everybody's stronger, the physicality of the game. It makes you tired. Like when my first game, I was exhausted, you know, just the speed of the game. And ever since then, Coach Barnes had me do like 17 drills, stuff like that, just to make sure I'm in shape. But he's like just the mental mind of the game. I learned that, you know, it just don't come your way. It's not easy. You got to work hard for it. Every single possession counts in the game. And, you know, basketball, it can mess with you in a mental-wise. You know, just keeping your composure and just blocking all that out and just keeping mind right and focusing on winning games. Coach Barnes, you know, he's a great coach. And, you know, I take the challenge, you know, to come here and be coached by him.
The freshman guard admired the relationships Coach Barnes has with his point guards. And you can see how much he cares by the way they communicate on the court.
Those conversations, him getting on to me, honestly, or him trying to explain something to me, you know, him just showing me something that he sees on the court while he's watching. You know, he sees things while he's watching, and I see things while I'm on the court, honestly. So ever since the Texas game, TJ Ford, he had a talk with me, so it was a great conversation. You know, I've asked some questions how just during a moment game where we're down, I asked him, what did he do? And, you know, he told me just, you know, be you and just be communicating with Coach Barnes. And if Coach Barnes see me quiet, he probably thinks something's wrong, you know, that I'm not the same person as he recruited me. So he's like, if he see me communicating with him, he know that, you know, I'm still engaged in the game even though things are not going well. So for him, he just told me to be communicating with Coach Barnes.
Alley-oop, that time works. Kennedy Chandler to John Fulkerson.
Man, that's faster than I thought it was. I feel like we just started playing, you know, basketball this season. And, you know, trying to keep our mind focused, you know, and just continue to win games, honestly. And, you know, the SEC term is coming up, so we just got to continue to get better each and every single day and find new things that we need to get better with the offensive end and defensive end. And, you know, it's coming up. March is coming up and SEC term, so, you know, we just got to continue to get better every single day.
For the Rick Barnes Show, I'm Casey Funderburg.